HCVarma, Chapter 9, Question Number 18. A neutron initially at rest decays into a proton, an electron and an antineutrino. The ejected electron has a momentum of 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 26 kg meter per second and the antineutrino 6.4 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg meter per second. Find the recoil speed of the proton. A. If the electron and antineutrino are ejected along the same direction, and B, if they are ejected along perpendicular directions. As the neutron is initially at rest, the initial momentum of the system is zero. There is no external force on the system, therefore its momentum must be conserved. In other words, the momentum gained by proton must be equal in magnitude and opposite to direction of net momentum gained by electron and antineutrino. In part A of the question, electron and antineutrino move in the same direction. Therefore, the direction of momentum of both the particles is same and the net magnitude of the momentum gained by these two particles is 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 26 plus 6.4 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg meter per second. If V be the speed gained by the proton, then its momentum is Mp into V, where Mp is the mass of the proton. The momentum of proton is equal in magnitude to the sum of momenta of electron and antineutrino. Thus, Mp into V is equal to 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 26 plus 6.4 into 10 to the power minus 27, which implies V is equal to 2.04 into 10 to the power minus 26 divided by Mp. Putting the value of Mp, we get V is equal to 2.04 into 10 to the power minus 26 divided by 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 27. Simplifying, we get the speed of proton is equal to 12.2 meters per second. This is answer to the first part of the question. For second part, the electron and antineutrino are moving along perpendicular lines. Let the direction of motion of electron be x-axis and the direction of motion of antineutrino be y-axis. As the combined momentum of electron and antineutrino has components along both the axes, the required speed of the proton too will have components along x and y-axis. Let its speed along x-axis be vx and y-axis be vy. Conserving the momentum of the system along x-axis, we get Mp into Vx is equal to momentum of electron, which implies Vx is equal to momentum of electron divided by mass of proton, or 1.4 into 10 to the power minus 26 divided by 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 27, which on simplification gives 8.38 meter per second. Similarly, momentum of proton along y-axis must be equal to the momentum of antineutrino, or Mp into Vy is equal to momentum of antineutrino, which implies Vy is equal to 6.4 into 10 to the power minus 27 divided by 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 27, which on simplification gives 3.83 meter per second. The final speed of the proton is the resultant of these two perpendicular velocities, that is root under Vx square plus Vy square, which implies the speed of proton is equal to root under 8.38 square plus 3.83 square, that is 9.2 meters per second. This is answer to part B of the question. In order to request solution to any question from HCVarma book, post the question number and chapter number in comments below. Like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe the channel, like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter for latest updates. Thank you for watching.